Okay, good morning, good morning. Here we go, low impact hit. Oh, we are gonna use weights for one of our circuits, but other than that, it's gonna be all body weight. So, let's go ahead and start with our warm up. We're gonna start over to one side and just sort of do a lateral squat walk. So we're gonna get nice and low, squat walk. 1, 2, three, and you're gonna stand up nice and tall on your toes at the end, and then reach to the other side. 1, 2, 3, and lift. So I want you to keep doing this. I didn't actually grab my stopwatch, Bill. So I'll be right back. Keep doing that for about 20 more seconds. Let me grab my stopwatch. Okay, I'm back and back. Let's go about 5 more seconds. Lateral squat walk. Getting nice and low. Warming up those legs. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, so now we're gonna do our good mornings. We're gonna do 10 of these. So hands behind our head. Feet right underneath those hips. Okay, we're gonna hinge forward at the hips. Create a nice flat back. Push into those heels and lift. That's 1. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift for 2. So you're bending those knees slightly. Flat back. 3. Inhale, start to pull those abs in. Exhale, 4. We lower and lift for 5. Let's do 5 more. So we're a nice flat back. Lift. Here's number 6. Push into those heels as you lift up. We inhale, lower. Exhale, up. Down. Squeeze to lift. We're going to do 1 more. Good morning. Warming up the back of those legs. And up. Excellent. Okay. Arms down. Let's go ahead and just roll those shoulders. I actually want to take your hands on top of your shoulders. You're going to imagine making circles with your elbows. So you're going to bring them up, down, and around. Working through those shoulders. Big circles. So instead of arm circles, making circles with your elbows here, opening up the shoulders. So we're going to do 5 more of these. 5, 4, let's do a couple more. 3, really opening up the shoulders. 2 more big circles. And last one. All right, perfect. Okay, next exercise warm up is going to be a single leg deadlift. Okay, so we'll start with that left leg back. You're going to put all your weight on that right leg back, I'm sorry. Weight on that left knee, okay? So we're going to tuck those hips under, pull those abs in. Okay, we're going to lower our chest, lift that back leg. It can be slightly bent, and then we're going to come back up. So we're going to hinge forward, we're going to lower, and lift. We're going to do 10 on each side. So this is number 3. Arms are straight. Back is flat. Oh, hey, Linda, welcome. This is number 4. Keeping that back flat. Inhale and balance. Exhale, 5. Let's do 5 more on the side. Down. Ooh. Try not to fall over. 6. So single leg deadlift. Pull those shoulder blades together. 7. 8, you're gonna do 2 more and then we'll switch into the other side. So just kick that leg up. Good, last one, pulling those abs in. Ooh, try to fall over. Okay, let's switch to the other side. So same thing, tucking those hips under. This time our left leg goes up, bending our right knee. Here we go. You lower and lift. Hip hinge. Just inhale, lower. Exhale, up, that's 2. Try to flatten your foot here, maybe using the wall for a little balance if you need to. Take that heel up. 4. Lower. Or 5. We got 5 more to go. Let's body get a little bit warmer here. That's 6. We can bend that back knee a little bit if you need to. That's a little bit easier. There's 7. Couple more. Inhale, lower. Exhale, up for 8. We've got 2 more. Down. And left, good. Last one, keeping the back nice and flat. Inhale and exhale. Excellent. Okay, last warm exercise. We're gonna do some forward lunges. We're gonna start with those feet together. I want you to reach forward a little bit when you do your lunge. So we step out, lean forward, pull ourselves back. Alternate. Okay, so we're gonna do 8 on each side. Here's 2. Inhale, exhale. Here's number 3. We lean forward a little bit, reach down through those shoelaces. Try to fall over like I did. Here's 4. So a lot of core, a lot of balance here. Reach and lift. Here's 5. Reach and pull up. Okay, almost there. We've got 6. 2 more sets. 7. Push yourself back up. Okay, last set. 1 more on the right and left. Step out. Pull up. Last one. All right, great job. Let's come to the center. Should be nice and warm. We'll continue to get warm with our first circuit. Let's bring our feet nice and wide. Okay, we'll do a full body roll. Shoulders, bend the knees, inhale, lower. Exhale, round it up. And let's do that again, inhale. And exhale, roll it up. Okay, let's do it one more time. You're gonna stay nice and low. Bring those knees out. Moving those hips side to side. Go ahead and take that right shoulder in. Come back to the center, switch other side. And then roll it up slowly. Making circles with our knees this time, open up our hips, similar to our shoulders that we did earlier, and just open it up. All right, hope you guys had a great weekend. You are ready to work. Our first circuit is all body weight, okay? So first exercise is gonna be a fast inchworm walkout. You have similar upper body and weight on your wrists. So you can do this on your forearms if you want to. Okay, you're gonna stay nice and low here. So quickly, you're gonna walk it out, walk it back. But you don't ever come up. So see how I stay low the whole time. So I'm here, I walk, I find a nice strong plank, walk back quickly. Walk, 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 come back up. Okay, so again, you could do that on your forearms and just maybe slow it down a little bit. Exercise number 2, squat, alternating kick. So we're here, squat, alternating front kick. But it's not this kind of kick, it's a straight kick. So from the side, see? So we're reaching the opposite foot. Squat, reach. A straight kick, getting the hamstrings nice and warm. And then we have plank taps plus a shoulder tap. So you're here. All right, you're gonna tap your foot and your shoulder at the same time. Tap, tap. So when I'm tapping to my right shoulder, it's my right foot going out. Watch one more time. Tap, tap. Okay, shoulder and foot at the same time. So let's start with our fast walkout, all right? Fast inchworm walkout, we'll go for about 45 seconds. So on your hands or on your forearms, right? Okay, first round. We go in 3, stay low. 2, and go. So fast, walk it out. Find that plank, walk it back quickly. Stay low, walk it out. Keep it up, guys. So you're just taking out the standing up part. Oh no, I'm sorry, Linda. Okay, so Linda, you're gonna do your feet instead. Okay, you're gonna lower, can you do a forearm plank? Keep going, Belle, can you do a forearm plank, Linda? Yes? Okay, forearm plank, watch me, Linda. Keep going, Belle. Just gonna walk your feet up, Linda. Walk back out. Walk your feet. Okay? And if that bothers you, hold your plank and just focus on core. So we have a couple more seconds, guys. We got 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, come on up. We have a squat into that front kick. In 4, 3, 2, remember it's that straight kick. You squat first, straight kick. So it's the opposite hand to opposite leg. So get nice and low on your squat. And then kick. Keep going, guys. Now my knees are a little bent. My hamstrings are super tight. So again, just do what you can. Perfect. Keep it up, guys. Look at that. squat, and kick. Keep it up, guys. If you really want to get that heart rate up, find those levels where you get really low and then really high to tap that front kick to bring your foot. We've got 4, 3, 2, and 1. Okay, last one on this circuit. All right, so we're doing plank taps, hand, shoulder. Linda, I'll give you something different. Still, get ready, go. Tap, tap. Okay, so Linda, for this one, instead, since we're working the side core a little bit, I want you to Russian twist, okay? No issues with the shoulders here. So instead, you're just gonna tap with your arms. Go ahead and start, guys. It's a shoulder tap and a foot tap. Same side. Keep that head up in your plank. Keep it up. You can also do this on your forearms, Bill, and just do the foot taps. No shoulder taps. Right? Same exact thing. Keep going, guys. Wherever you're at, keep your shoulders away from your ears. Okay? Shoulders down. Woo! Pull those abs in. We've got 3, 2, 1. All right, back to exercise number 1, so stay right there. Okay, Linda, you're gonna do your forearm plank. You're gonna walk your feet in and out. Bill, you're gonna do the inchworm walk out. Okay, ready, set, round 2. And go. Walk it out, either with your hands or your feet. Keep it up. So Bill, you can do the same thing Linda's doing if you want to just walk the feet in, or I'll show you the forearm version. So forearm version. Forearms, you're walking them up. Woo! Either way, you keep those hips up. Keep it up, guys, inchworm walkout with hands or feet. Keep moving, keep moving. Perfect, and let me know if that's okay. You guys, we got about 6 more seconds here. And then we're gonna come up for that squat and alternating front kick. You've got 4, 3, 2, stand up. All right, squat and front kick. 3, 2, go. Get nice and low, kick. Let's keep that heart rate up. Let's keep that heart rate up. Get nice and low on that squat. Add that kick, guys. Keep it up. Good. Every other exercise should be good, Linda, except for one other one. That'll give you an option. Keep moving, guys. About 15 more seconds. Can you get a little lower in your squat? Now, when you kick, I want you to be using those abs, right? Crunch with the abs and kick. Couple more seconds. And then we're coming to our shoulder tap, plank tap, or our Russian twist tap. All right, 3, 2, and stop. Okay, so plank and shoulder tap, right? This is what we're doing on the floor, or your Russian twist tap. Ready, set, and go. So plank and shoulder tap, or you're in that boat pose, legs lifted, you're tapping side to side with your hands. You're keeping those shoulders away from those ears. Reach and twist using that core. We're working through the side body with this exercise, whichever version you're doing. Perfect. If you're seated, lean back a little bit and your shoulders away from those ears. Pull those abs in, whether you're seated or in your plank. Keep it up, guys, keep it up. A couple more seconds. I'm gonna go through this one more time through, a little bit shorter for that final round. You've got 3, 2, 1. All right, inchworm walkout. Final round, 30 seconds. Hands, walk with your forearms, or use your feet. Walk your feet up instead, okay? Ready, set, final round, go. So I'm gonna do my hands first. Walk out. and strong walkout. Hands or feet. Now I'm gonna do the feet. Relax the head. Walk your feet up. Walk them back out. All abs for this one. Woo. Keep it up, guys. You're moving your arms. You're moving your feet. You only have 5 more seconds. Keep it up. Pull those abs in. 3, 2, stand up. Squat. Alternating kick. Come on. 30 seconds. I'm gonna keep that heart rate going. Go. Down. Reach. All abs here. Woo. Get low in your squat. And then reach. Woo. Come on. Keep moving, guys. This is only 30 seconds. Okay? I want you to keep moving. Maybe a little faster if you're feeling comfortable with it. Come on, 3 to go. All right, come down to the floor. Side plank or taps with your hands. Ready, set, 30 seconds, and go, go. Working the side body, come on. So you can do this on your forearms and just do the foot taps. Keep going. Alternate version. Boat pose, tap with your hands, twist. Come on. Slow it down. Bring out the waist. A couple more seconds. Then we'll get our first break. Come on, push through. Tap, twist. Come on. 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, guys, take a breather. Quick breather. Grab some water. All right, how we doing? Okay? Sun's coming up now. Okay, so our next time we're gonna use weights. So we have a lunge and, core first, then a lunge and curl combo. Okay, so core, sprinter abs, all right? So no weight for this one. Body weight's perfect, all right? Legs are straight, arms overhead. You can also just have your arms down here for your, if that bothers your shoulders, okay? I'm gonna take my opposite elbow to my opposite knee, like I'm sprinting. All the way down, switch. So you guys see that? I go elbow to knee, like I'm sprinting. So you have to come all the way down in between in order to really work those abs, okay? Next one is a lunge and curl. So you're gonna lunge, you're gonna curl while you lunge, and we come up here, upright row in between. So you could absolutely take out that row. It shouldn't be too hard on the shoulders, but I'll let you guys decide that, okay? Curl as you lunge. And then our last one, this is the one that I can change for you guys. All right, it's mountain climbers into a side plank. So what we're gonna do instead is high knees or just a fast march. Oh, you know what, let's do this instead. Fast feet, hop, okay? Because that's still low impact, all right? Fast feet, and then a little hop over, okay? Because the key to there is working core. So let's start with our sprinter sit-ups. Okay, all the way down on your back. Remember, it's opposite elbow to opposite knee. Arms and legs are straight out. And you gotta reach that opposite elbow to your knee as you sit up. 3, 2, and start. So to the first couple with you guys if you wanna watch again. Make sure form is right. Remember that you come all the way down in between, okay? But you also have to come all the way up, right? And bring that elbow to your opposite knee like you are sprinting. Legs straight until you lift. And arms straight overhead. Woo! It's inhale back, exhale lift. Ooh, I'm feeling this already. Remember, for the shoulders, you can just have your arms down by your side if overhead is too bothersome, right? You can just have your hands at your chest. Like I'm doing. Woof. It's actually a little bit harder if you keep your hands by your chest because you have no momentum. We've got 4, 3, 2. All right, stand up. Lunge and curl. Here we go. Woo. So try a set of heavy weights if you got them. Okay, we're gonna alternate, so it doesn't matter which leg we start with. I'm gonna start with my right though. Feet together, here we go. Start, lunge and curl. And then before switching, if you can, add the upright row. Lunge and curl, upright row. So we're alternating here. Lunge and curl. And then at the top there, an upright row. For your hands come to about your chest and elbows out. So again, you can just do that curl with your lunge. Woo. Keep your head up, guys. Elbows in, let me see it.
Nice, perfect. Nice, good job, guys. Yep, elbows go straight out and up. Yeah, there we go. So you should feel the top of your shoulders, but it shouldn't feel painful, right? It's not overhead.
That should be okay for you. 5 more seconds, gonna get a little lower. Maybe move a little faster. Pull those abs in. 3, 2, 1, weights down. Actually, let's hold one of our weights. Fast feet with a little hop, all right? You're gonna hold your weight, it's right here at your chest. So hold it away from your belly, okay? Ready, set, fast feet. And then I'm gonna say hop. Fast feet. It's sort of like a little log jump. Hop. Hop. So fast feet until I say hop. To the side, hop. Hop. Shoulders down, keep that weight in front of your chest, hop. We don't want it straight out, but somewhere in the middle, hop. Keep moving, keep moving. Hop. Now straight out is gonna be harder for your core, but if it hurts your shoulder, hop. Then pull it back in, okay? So maybe try for a few seconds. Hop. Woo, I feel those abs. Hop. 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 Step. Woo, back to our first one. Sprint your abs. Come on down, great job. 5 seconds, sprint your abs. I'm keeping my arms at my chest, okay? 3, 2, go. Sprint your abs. Remember, it's opposite elbow to your knee. I want you to lift up and really try to reach your elbow to that knee, guys. Lift up a little higher. There's no rush for this. Okay? Woo. Keep moving. Keep it up, guys. Looking good. You got less than 15 seconds. How are we doing? Woo! Remember, keep those arms at your chest if you're feeling your shoulders. They don't have to go all overhead. You've got 4 seconds. 3, 2, and 1. Stand up. Lunge and curl. Upright row, try something heavy. We start in 3, 2, chest up, abs in, go. Lunge and curl. Elbows in, guys. Can you get a little lower in that lunge? Can you pull those elbows into your side? Woo! As you curl. Keep going, guys. Exhale as you lift up. Nice job. Excellent. Yep. Pull those abs in. Tight butt around that waist, right? Inhale, step back. Exhale, upright row. We've got 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold on to one of those. Or maybe both with the right foot challenge. Remember, hold out in front of you. Halfway, fast feet. Fast feet, go. Hop. 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 Keep going, keep going. Hop. Can you take that weight away from your chest a little bit? Hop, pull those abs in. Hop. Arms a little straighter, hop. Hop. Woo, feel those abs. Hop. Hop. And stop. Okay, back to our first one. Sprint your abs one more time through. Sprint your abs. You could add a weight here, or maybe two lighter weights. Just be careful of your shoulder, so just an option. All right, ready, set. 3, 2, and go. Some right hands up at chest. Reach and twist. Keep it up, guys. Listen to your body, but also work hard. You got this. Keep it up. All the way down, all the way up, guys. You have to hit the floor behind you before you come back up, okay? Sprinter. So elbow to your knee like you're sprinting. Lift up and twist. Woo! Hello, abs. Woo, come on, guys. Keep going, a few more seconds. Remember, this is a little shorter. 3, 2, stand up. Let's go. Lunging curl, front row. Just 30 seconds. Grab those heaviest weights that you got. 3, 2, chest up, abs in. Let's go. Curl, row. Can you keep those elbows in? As you curl and upright row, guys. Woo, keep it moving. It's inhale, exhale. Inhale, step back and curl. Exhale, row it up. Keep moving. A little bit shorter, let's try about 5 more seconds. And then we have our fast feet and our hop. You've got 3, 2, 1. Grab one or both dumbbells. Be fast, I want you to fast feet until I say hop, okay? If you want the higher impact, feel free to do a bigger hop. All right, fast feet start. Hop. Hop. So bring those knees up. Hop. Hop. You can even step it. Hop. Oh, I didn't say it. Hop. Hop. Arms straighter. Hop. Woo, feel those abs. Hop. Hop. And stop. Woo. All right, grab some water. Looking good, guys. We got one more circuit to go. One more. So, let's grab some water. Woo. How's everyone doing? We good? Thumbs up. Cool. All right. So here we're doing battle circuit. Body weight. First one is a pulsing push-up. How many mat here? And I'll give you an option. If the push-up, you shouldn't feel in your shoulders, but you might. So I'll give you an option. But let me just show you first. Pulsing push-up. Oh, yeah. So knees, hands wide, a little wider than shoulders. Okay? You come down and you pulse. So pulse, pulse, push-up. One more time. Tuck the hips under. It's pulse, pulse, and press. You guys see that? So another way that you can do that to help with your shoulders but still get the push-up is elevating it. So maybe you have a bench or a wall that you can do push-ups on, and then you don't have all your weight on your shoulders. So you're still doing a push-up a little bit differently, or even on the bed, okay? So then we have a side-to-side lunge. So we're gonna punch and punch. So see how I'm rotating my hips here? I'm staying low. You can add weight if you want. So up, rotate. You wanna watch the knees with that one. And then our final one. Oh yeah, this one's fun with the weight. Okay, one dumbbell. Hollow hold, legs up. While doing a chest fly, pass. Okay, so just passing that dumbbell. You can try to actually throw it, but I'll just be careful. Okay, just passing that dumbbell. If you want harder, legs lower, right? Heavy dumbbell, because the idea is that when that weight is on one side, you're working those obliques, right? And you're kind of tick-tocking. So heavy, heavy weight for that. If you don't want to do the push-ups, you guys know chest press is gonna be that other alternative with two weights. So let's start with our pulsing push-up, okay? Either elevated or chest press. All right, I'm gonna do them on my knees so I don't hurt my back. Okay, you guys ready? Remember, it's a pulse, pulse, up. Okay, round one. Hands shoulder distance, tuck those hips under. Ready, set, go. It's pulse, pulse, all the way up, and repeat. Pulse, pulse, all the way up. Pulse, pulse, all the way up. Remember, your elbows go straight back, guys. You should feel your chest, you should feel your core, your back a little bit too. Let's keep going. You're about halfway. Make sure to pull those abs in. Pulse, pulse, all the way up. It's pulse, pulse, all the way up. It's pulse, pulse, all the way up. Keep going. Keep that neck long. Woo, we got 5 seconds wherever you're at. 4, 3, 2, stand up. Stand up. Side to side punches. I'm doing no weight. You can grab some light weights. Remember that we shift the hips completely. Okay? Ready, set, go. So I'm basically doing a lunge in each direction. I'm adding that punch. So keep moving. Remember, the key is rotating those hips. Keep moving. You want to watch your knees specifically here. Yep. Yeah, you guys got it. All the way side to side. Can you drop your hips a little lower, though? Yes. There we go. Getting that heart rate up. Lunge. It's just a little hop. Not even a full jump. Woo! Getting those in and out of thighs. Come on. Keep moving. Remember, we do it 3 times, so maybe you add a weight next time. If you need a little more intensity. 3, 2, 1. Hollow hold. Chest fly. Passing that heavy dumbbell, right? Okay, here we go. Push your back into the floor. I'll let you choose how low the legs go. It's up to you. Ready, set, go. Head up the whole time. Fly. Chest fly. Both arms lower. But only one side has that weight. Try to keep your head, neck, and shoulders up. Woo! I'm feeling those abs. Passing that dumbbell. So I'm not actually throwing my abs. Nice and easy, going from one side to the other. Now remember, your legs don't move, and you make them a little lower. Everyone drop an inch. Drop your legs an inch, guys. Come on, there we go. Can you flatten your back a little bit harder? Flatten your back. Come on. Woo! Remember, arms open. They almost touch the floor. Not quite, but you're close. 3, 2, 1. That's those push-ups. Woo! That's those push-ups. Round two, guys. Or a weighted chest press. You choose. All right, here we go. 3, 2. And go. It's pulse, pulse, up. Pulse, pulse, up. I want to see that pulse, guys. Pulse, pulse, up. Or chest press, same thing. You pulse, pulse, and then extend your arms to the top. Keep up, guys. Keep going. You're a little more than halfway. And maybe you're doing the elevated push-up, right? That will help. Perfect. Yep, good, Linda. It's pulse, pulse, and press. Yep. Nice, Bill. Keep that head up. You got this. Tuck those hips under. Woo! Come on, guys. We got this. 5 more seconds. And stop. Stand up. Side to side lunge. Woo! With that punch, maybe with weights. Okay. Ready, set, go. Keep your head up. Punch, punch. You want to stay low here in that lunge. Keep going, guys. I want you to go all the way side to side. Yes, Linda, you got it. Good. Keep those hips nice and low. You got it, Bill. Woo. Just watch your feet. Watch your knees. Stay low. Woo. Keep moving. Less than 10 seconds.
Punch straight up, guys. You got it. Okay, you can go punch a little down, Linda, if that feels better on your shoulders. Yeah, just let me know.
3, 2, go. Stop. Hollow hold. Our chest fly, right? Remember, both arms go down. It's a regular fly. You're just passing the weight from side to side, okay? Ready, set, and go. One dumbbell, go. Chest fly. Open, switch, open, switch to the top, open. Woo! Keep your head, neck, and shoulders up, guys, if you can. You should feel that slight pull on the side that the dumbbell is on every time it lowers, right? Those are your core muscles working. Can you press your back a little harder into the floor? Let's see it. Can you get your legs a little lower, inch lower? Glue those heels together, keep your legs together. Pull those inner thighs. Come on, head up. Woo! Keep it up. 4, 3, 2, 1. Awesome job, guys. Come on up. Final round. Final round. Let's do it. Back to our push-ups or chest press. Okay. Ready, set. 3, 2, go. Pause, pause. Push. Up those hips under. Come on, head up. Elbows back, guys. Come on. Pulse, pulse, press. Whether you're doing that chest press or that actual push-up. Pulse, pulse, press. Woo! Can we try 10 more seconds? This round's a little bit shorter. Let's make it a little better. Come on. Woo! Arms are feeling it. What about now? Woo! Keep up. You've got 3, 2, stand up. Awesome job. Side to side lunge. 30 seconds, guys. Ready, set, go. 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 You can punch down if you need to. Maybe add some weight. Keep going.
Keep it up. Either way, let's keep those hips low. Come on, Bill. You got it.
Come on, 5 seconds. And stop. Hollow hold. Chest fly pass. Ready, set, ready, step. Last time, guys. 3, 2, go. Flat back, let's go. Inhale, open, exhale, up. Come on, guys, you got this. You can always keep your head down if you really need to. Let's try to lift your head, neck, and shoulders. Lower your head, your legs an inch. Keep it up, guys. You get 5 more seconds. Lower those legs. Flatten your back. 3, 2, and 1. All right, guys. Stand up. We have 1 minute of work left. We're just going to go all out for one final minute. All right. And we're doing our skater hops. You can keep it nice and low here or add a little jump. Final minute, then we are done, okay? Ready, set. Let's go. Full body, guys. Come on. So low impact, just big step, but add that reach. Work the core. Come on. One final minute. You got this, guys. Woo. Keep going, guys. We're done up for this.
You have about 30 seconds. If you're feeling good, maybe pick up that pace.
I'm gonna add a little hop here. Guys, come on, keep it up. Stop. Woo. Good job, guys.
Walk it out, get some water. How are we doing? Thumbs up.
Awesome. All right, water quickly. And we'll stretch. My heart rate's up. Whew. Big deep breaths in through the nose. Out through the mouth. All right, let's find the center of our space here. Crisscross those arms. Shake it out. Awesome job this morning. Whew, thanks for coming, guys. Shoulder rolls. Up and back. Boom, boom, boom. All right, feet nice and wide. Let's do a full body roll, starting with the shoulders. Big inhale. Bend the knees, arch the back slightly. And then exhale, round the back. Roll it up nice and slow. And let's do that again. Big inhale, lower. Big exhale, lift. One more time. We're going to stay nice and low here. Bring those feet maybe a little bit wider. Let's just sort of shift your hips here side to side. And then drop that shoulder. Come to the center, drop the other shoulder. All right, so lateral lunge, you're gonna bend that left knee. Get that right leg nice and straight. You're shifting your hips back. Okay, inhale up, exhale down one more time. Hold it, we don't wanna put all of our weight on that leg. But you can place your hands there. Your weight's behind you. Okay, inhale up, exhale, let's go to the other side. So same thing. Hold that there for a few seconds. Bending that right knee. And then inhale up, exhale. One more time, remember, you're shifting your weight back. Hands just on that leg for balance. We don't want all of our weight on it. Okay, now we're gonna let all that weight go. We'll fold forward. We'll just show you from the side here. Feel free to bend your knees. Let's relax our head completely. Press your palms into the floor, or maybe you're resting on a block or a towel. If you can't reach the floor. And then we're gonna put our weight into our heels. I'm sorry, our toes. So lift your heels off the floor, and then lift your toes off the floor. We're sort of shifting our weight front and back, rocking front and back. And back to the center. Grab those opposite elbows, ragdoll, relax your head, sway side to side. And then we'll heel toe our feet together, nice and slow, or just walk your feet together, right? Bend the knees, roll it up slowly, nice and slow. Roll those shoulders. Okay, let's do a couple on the floor here. So almost done. Got about 2 minutes left. We'll find a cat-cow. Okay, hands under the shoulders. Knees under those hips. Inhale, lift. Belly drops. Chest lifts. Exhale, chin to chest. And repeat. Two more times. Inhale. Exhale. One more. Inhale. And exhale. Great, let's take our right foot forward, come into a nice hip flexor stretch. Hold this here, make sure your back toe is untucked, nice and flat. And if you wanna add a little twist here, this might not feel good on your shoulders, so maybe not, but I'll just show you. Take your hand down and you can reach and twist. So I usually take my hand and my elbow. So I still get that rotation in my shoulder and my chest. I just can't quite extend through my arm, right? But I can still get that twist. So you can do that. And then come back to center. Come back up. And let's go ahead and switch. Let's now take that left leg forward. So you can stay right here, hip flexor. Pressing through those hips. Keep the chest up. You can go ahead and add that twist. hands come down first, and then reach and twist with that opposite arm, or hand to your hips here, and just twist with your elbow up and through that shoulder. So you're still opening up through the chest and the shoulder without hurting or having your arm be painful or shoulder here. And then slowly come back up, nice and easy, let's find. Let's come down to our belly, we'll do our quad stretch, we're almost done. Quad stretch, look to the right, grab your right foot. Press and hold. And then release, other side, same thing. Press and hold. And then release, go ahead and gently press yourself up. Child's pose would be this last one here. So knees wide, sitting back into your heels, relax the head. All right, let's tuck the toes. We will roll up to standing. You'll meet me in the middle of your workout space. Nice and slow, roll it up. Just squeeze those shoulder blades together. Open up through the chest. And then go ahead and release, shake it out. All right, guys, inhale, we'll reach up. Exhale, we'll bend the knees, shake it out. And then one more time, inhale up. And then exhale, shake it out. Woo! All right, you did it. Great job, guys, happy deal.